NASA have sent many spacecraft in space to observe the various phenomena occurring in the universe, starting from collecting samples from the moon's surface and ending at looking for habitable exoplanets. This space agency has provided a lot of information, and now they have been able to collect samples from an asteroid. Well, stay tuned to Gateway to Knowledge to know how NASA's new spacecraft has successfully touched the asteroid Bennu. This well-preserved ancient asteroid is more than 2 million miles away from the Earth. The asteroid Bennu offers scientists a window into the early solar system as it was first taking shape billions of years ago and throwing away ingredients that could have helped seed life on Earth. OSIRIS-REx spacecraft has touched its robotic arm on the asteroid Bennu, and it is able to collect dust and pebbles from the surface, which will be delivered to the Earth in 2023. On this Tuesday, the OSIRIS-REx finds its thruster to nudge itself out of orbit of the asteroid Bennu. It extended its shoulder, then elbow, and then its wrist, which is about 11 foot in length, and it is also called as the sampling arm, which the scientists have given the name as Touch and Go. After a 4-hour descent at an altitude of approximately 410 feet, the spacecraft executed the checkpoint burn, the first of the two maneuvers to allow it to precisely target the sample collection site known as the Nightingale. 10 minutes later, the spacecraft fired its thruster for the second match point burn to slow its descent and match the asteroid rotation at the time of contact. It then continued to rotate around the asteroid for about 11 minutes to touch down the spot in a crater of the Bennu's northern hemisphere. The size of the Nightingale site is one of the few relatively clearly spots on the unexpected space rock, a piece of primordial rock that has witnessed our solar system's entire history may now be ready to come home from generations of scientific discovery, and we can't wait to see what comes next. After over a decade of planning, the team is overjoyed at the success of today's sampling attempt. All spacecraft telemetry data indicates that the THE event executed as expected. However, it will take about a week for the OSIRIS-REx team to confirm how much sample the spacecraft collected. But the real-time data indicates that it have successfully contacted the surface and fired a burst of nitrogen gas. The gas should have stripped up dust and pebbles of Bennu's surface, some of which should have been captured in the sample collection head. The spacecraft carried out TAGE autonomously with pre-programmed instructions from engineers on the Earth. Now the OSIRIS-REx team will begin to assess whether the spacecraft grabbed any material, and the goal of it was to collect at least 60 grams, which is roughly the size of a full-size candy bar. The engineers and scientists will use several techniques to identify and measure the samples remotely. Firstly, they will compare images of the Nightingale site before and after TAGE to see how much surface material moved around in response to the burst of gas. Next, the team will try to determine the amount of sample collected. One method involves taking picture of the collection head with a camera that is known as SAMCAM, which is devoted to documenting the sample collection process and determining whether dust and rock made it into the collector head. One indirect indication will be the amount of dust found around the sample collector head. The OSIRIS-REx engineers will also attempt to snap photos that could give the right lighting conditions to show the inside of the head so that the engineers could look for evidence of sample inside of it. And to store the sample, the engineers will command the robotic arm to place the sample collector head into the sample return capsule that is located in the body of the spacecraft. The sample arm will then retract to the side of the spacecraft for the final time, and then it will close and the spacecraft will prepare for its departure from the Bennu in March 2021. And if it turns out that the spacecraft didn't collect enough sample at the Nightingale, it will attempt another THE maneuver on January 12th in 2021. If that occurs, it will touch down at the backup site called the Osprey, which is another relatively boulder-free area inside a crater near Bennu's equator. So this sample collection from the asteroid Bennu's surface will provide us to understand the origin of Earth and life as we know it. And to know more about such interesting and amazing facts, do subscribe to my channel and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified about my latest videos.